there, Janet Fritz here for Galaxy Girl Creations. Welcome to my channel. Welcome to the bonus layout for Kit Conspiracy that is made with the remainders of all of my kits combined. And actually, I'm not using product from all of the kits combined. I am using some papers from the last kit. I believe this is from the last week. And in the attempt to use more paper, I'm going to back my photos with that white canvassy looking paper, or burlappy looking paper. And so I will essentially be using the wood grain, that strip of the camping stuff at the bottom. That was like the leftovers from the Christmassy looking layout that I did earlier in the week. And, so the other side has just like a partial of the watercolor on it. And then it's, kind of fades out, so it wasn't really exciting. So I thought I would use the camping motif there because I am documenting my son at an overnight camp out for Cub Scouts. I was trying to remember if it's Cub Scouts or Boy Scouts. It is Cub Scouts. So I am, like I said, going to use this paper to go ahead and back all of these photos rather than pulling out my white cardstock. I think it's going to look fine. So I did trim them down so that they would fit a little bit better on my page, since I do have four photos and two of them are pretty close to, well, I trimmed them down. They're not true 4x6. I trimmed off what I could. The one that I'm cutting out now, I really couldn't cut a lot more off of it because the kids go all the way out to the edges. So, I just trimmed them down as best as I could to kind of make them fit. And I know they're kind of oddball sizes, and I normally try to keep them the same height, but then that would make those two wide ones really like narrow and squatty. But I am going to trim them down a little bit more, so spoiler alert, I'm going to trim the tops so they end up being closer to the same height. Although it looks pretty good how they're laid out right there. I could have left it like that, but I didn't. You know, I'm always moving things around. And so I took the paper that had all of the cut apart camping elements, and I fussy cut out a whole bunch of things. I cut out the campfire with the pot on top of it, the rabbit, the boots, the backpack, tent. I'm going to cut out some little cups. I think I cut out a second backpack, some flowers. I'm just cutting out a whole bunch of stuff kind of to go across the layout where that blue, where the two papers meet, basically. I wasn't going to use that round one that I just cut out there that says Into the Wild because it has a moose on it. We don't have any moose in California, but you know what? I thought I'm just going to go ahead and go with it. So we don't have moose, but that's okay. I'm not sure, like, maybe they could have just put a regular old mule deer on there or something, because those are like in a lot of different places, not just, I don't know. Maybe I'm just being picky. So I cut out the thermos, a lantern, cutting the flowers right now. I'm just kind of trying to make a strip of these embellishments across the center of the layout there. But I don't want to cover up a lot in the photos. I don't mind if a little bit's covered up, because like the boys in the photo I'm adhering right now, I don't even really remember who half of those kids are, but my son is in the turquoise shirt all the way to the right-hand side. And I suppose I could have just cut out him, but then you don't really get the overall look and feel of the place that we were at, or that he's at. And so I didn't want to cut all of it off, because then you, I mean, the other photo is nighttime, so you don't see anything of the nature or anything. And I wanted to make sure I kept some of that nature in. So that's why I just decided to go ahead and leave the other boys in there. He will probably remember most of their names. Although I can honestly say he went camping so many times because my husband was a camp director for a couple of the seasons, or for a couple of the camps. And there were so many boys that my son didn't know. So I could honestly tell you, he may not actually know who those kids are. So anyway, it is what it is, right? So I'm going to just go ahead and adhere most of these down. I am kind of layering them behind things and such, but I'm not adding a lot of dimension here just because like one half of the tent is under stuff. Well, actually the tent is all on top, but it is going to be under some stuff, I believe. But I've got stuff peeking out and like half the flowers are under the boots and the other half, now they're on top. I say that and then I move it. I do end up adding a few pieces that have some foam tape, but not everything. So a couple of the little coffee cups have some foam tape on them. I just decided I didn't really want, like if I put foam tape on the top of the thermos, but not the bottom because it's tucked in, it looks funny because it's not a flexible item. I don't know. It's not like a leaf. Then I added a couple of birds, just trying to make that just a pretty like border across there. And you can still see that blue diagonal stripe border strip that I used. I didn't want to cover that up completely. I wanted it to stay there so that you get the idea that it's a transition, something that your eye just kind of naturally decides on its own. It's not like a conscious decision that you made. Oh, look, there's a transition. So then I pulled out these little tiny alpha stickers from Paige Evans, and I'm going to use that for the title and the pack number. So he was in Cub Scout pack 340. He's 24 years old now, so he's not a little kid anymore. And none of the kids in these photos are still involved in scouting because they're all aged out. And then it has the name of the scout reservation that they went to way back in, I think these are 2007, 2008. Don't forget to check out what MK is doing today. This is our final layout that we agreed to do. Now, I think she and I both are going to be using our kits a little bit into May. I have at least two layouts, maybe more. We'll see. I'm not sure how many she has, but I'm super curious to see what she makes with the remainder of her kits and if she mixes and matches between the different collections, which I did not do. And I decided I needed to put some journaling somewhere. Where am I going to do that? So I pulled out a piece of my white cardstock and I just used this stamp. This is one of my favorite stamp sets and it is not available anymore. It is the labeled stamp by the Stamp Market. So I apologize that it's not available anymore. I do need to find some new label stamps that are available so that I quit like using the ones that nobody can get anymore because I know you guys like them. But if I find a really good one, I will let you guys know. So I'll be on the lookout for that. Then I decided to add a couple little embellishments down here in the bottom corner of that little label just to kind of bring the design down to that area. So I chose a cup with flowers in it and a pair of binoculars. And that leaves me plenty of room to write a little bit of journaling. The binoculars, I'm going to pop them up onto some foam tape. That is about it. I hope that you guys really enjoyed the series. I really had a great time with it and I know MK did too. I hope we have the opportunity to do this again. I know I've gotten a lot of feedback that a lot of people really enjoyed this series. Thank you so much for watching. I know a lot of you stuck with us throughout the entire series, and we really, really do appreciate it. I appreciate all of the comments that were left, and I really hope that you guys found some inspiration one way or another through either one of us. Thanks again for watching. We will see you guys again soon with another video. Bye-bye.